My name is Nikhila Tharuti from St. Martin's Engineering College, working as a faculty in S&S department. So in today's session, I'm going to explain you about capital budgeting techniques. So especially in this session, we'll discuss about the definition and the process of capital budgeting and the kinds of capital budgeting decisions and the methods which we use in order to conduct capital budgeting decision. So when it comes to definition, the definition is like capital budgeting technique is a long-term planning technique which every organization uses irrespective of their size and management. So when we say long-term, we only refers to the projects which have lifetime of more than 1 year. So all the projects which are having less than 1 year time comes under the short term. So when we're talking about capital budgeting, we are strictly mentioning it to be a long term decision. Then comes the process. The process would be, determining the projects which are available, so in this step we consider the alternatives that we have for the capital budgeting decision. In the next step would be analyzing the cash inflows of every project. And the third step would be applying appropriate capital budgeting technique. Applying appropriate capital budgeting technique becomes very important as we have several capital budgeting techniques which we can use for an evaluation of one project. And then the next step would be selecting the project. The selection of the project will be done based on its cash inflows and the decision rules of the technique that we are using. Then comes the last and but not the least step, monitoring and feedback. We have to regularly monitor our project in order to complete it successfully. So we are done with the process now. So we are left with kinds of the capital budgeting decisions and the techniques that we use in capital budgeting. Then it would be the next part would be kinds of capital budgeting decisions. The kinds of capital budgeting decisions that every organization needs to take are expansion decisions, and the replacement of asset decisions, and the R&D. That comes research and development, and there will be some other decisions that has to be taken. So if we take an example of expansion decision, if a company wants to expand its business to the another geographical location, it has to take the capital budgeting techniques and evaluate the project. Then comes the replacement decision. The replacement decision basically consider with assets. Whenever a company wants to replace an asset, it has to take a capital budgeting technique into consideration so that it can make effective decisions. When it comes to R&D involves greater capital inflow. So we need to take capital budgeting techniques carefully in order to achieve the better R&D decisions. Other decisions may be maybe buying a truck, maybe it may be buying a new building like that. So what we discussed, the examples of capital budgeting may be buying a new truck or building a new office place, or it may be expanding our geographical reach of the business. These are the some main examples of capital budgeting decisions which have to be taken very carefully. So then comes the most important part of this session, that is types of capital budgeting decisions. So in whenever we call types of capital budgeting, we have several types of capital budgeting techniques involved in this session, but we basically divide them into two types. Then we have some subtypes also. The first one would be traditional approaches, and the second one would be non-conventional, or we can call it to be as discounted cash flows techniques. So when it comes to traditional techniques, we have payback period method and the ARR method majorly. And when we call non-conventional methods, it would be NPV method, which is net present value method, and the IRR method and the profitability index method. So we'll discuss each of these in a very short manner. So let's take traditional or conventional methods. So in conventional method, we have payback period method and the ARR method. In these two methods, it will not consider the time value of money. So when we say time value of money, what we mean is the money that we are getting today is more valuable than the money that we may get in future. So the conventional methods never take time value of money in consideration. So we have payback period method and ARR method. So we'll discuss about payback period method first. Payback period. When we try to decode this word, we find that payback period, the name itself says that the time required to get our investment back on a particular project. So, what it means? The time in how many years we are going to get back our initial investment which we have made in a particular project. So the calculation of PBT is very easy, and the formula for this would be initial investment that we can call it as capital outlay divided by the annual cash inflows. So this is the formula for PBT, and it is very easy to calculate when we have values for everything. So let's take an example and calculate it. If you take an example, a project X is having capital outlay of, let's say, 1 lakh rupees. So, and it's having annual cash inflows as 10,000 for 5 years. Let's think, 50,000 for 5 years. So the question would be, in how many days we are, in how many years we are going to get back our investment? So calculate it by using this formula. What we have discussed, PBP is equals to initial investment by annual cash inflows. So here, this is would be an initial investment, that is 1 lakh. And this would be your annual cash inflows, that is 50,000. So by calculating it, we'll get 2 years. So here 2 years means in 2 years we are going to get our investment in our pocket again. So this is the end of the PBP. And there is also a decision rule for every technique, that would be for PBP. It would be, if PBP, that is payback period, is greater than the target year which we have freely defined, then we need to reject the project, as we are going to get the initial investment after the target year. So then if PBP is less than the target year, then we should accept the project. So then when comes the another traditional method, which is ARR, accounting rate of return. So the calculation of ARR goes like, ARR is equals to average annual profit divided by average investment. So here we need average annual profit and average investment. When it comes to average annual profit, we calculate it as profit 1 plus profit 2 plus profit 3, like n profit. Suppose we have profit of n, then we have to add these ones, and then we have to divide it with the number of profits that we have gained. So here we have n number of profits. Basically we are doing an average for profits. So when it comes to average investment, we will do that by dividing investment with 2. So this is the end of our accounting rate of return. These two are the traditional methods which never consider time value of money. Then we move on to non-conventional techniques, or we can call it to be as discounted techniques. So in this we have most important NPV and IRR, and then profitability index. First we will discuss about NPV. NPV is the most used capital budgeting technique in all the organizations. So we calculate NPV using the formula, that is present value of cash inflows minus present value of cash outflows. So if we get NPV as a negative, then we reject the project. For this, if we get NPV as positive, then we accept the project. in mutually exclusive project, whichever is having a higher NPV value, that has to be taken into consideration. So, the tabular form would be present value of cash inflows, and the present value of cash inflows at a given rate, and the DCIFs. So we have discussed NPV and its decision rules, and we also have IRR and profitability index. IRR is very easy. For IRR, we take NPV is equals to 0, and the decision rule will be if IRR, that is internal rate of return, is higher than the cost of capital, we accept the project. If IRR is less than the cost of the capital, we reject the project. So when it comes to profitability index, the formula would be present value of cash inflows divided by present value of cash outflows. When profitability is index is more than 1, we accept the project. When profitability index is less than 1, we reject the project. When profitability index is equals to 1, we set to be a break-even point. So, thank you.